Hello, my dear viewers. Welcome you all to Scorpio Class Hindi. In this video, I have brought complete notes of poem Abhinav Manushya along with explanation in English. So let us see. First main is ek vakya mein uttar likho. Answer in one sentence. First question, aaj ki duniya kaisi hai? How is the world today? So answer is, आज की दुनिया विचित्र और नवीन है. टुडेज वर्ल्ड इज स्ट्रेंज एंड न्यू. देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, मानव के हुक्म पर क्या चढ़ता और उतरता है? व्हाट राइजेस एंड फॉल्स ऑन द एडवाइस ऑफ मैन? आंसर, मानव के हुक्म पर पवन का ताप चढ़ता और उतरता है. द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर राइजेस एंड फॉल्स ऑन द एडवाइस ऑफ मैन. देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, परमाणु किसे देखकर कांपते हैं? Whom does nuclear weapons fear? आंसर, परमाणु मानव के करों को देखकर कांपते हैं. Nuclear weapons fear the works of human. Okay, here the exact meaning of kar, karo is a hand. So what human do with his hand? He does work or he take action, right? So here Parmanu is afraid that what action human will take, whether he will use me in a good way or he will use me to destroy some place. So this fear Parmanu has, this fear nuclear weapon has. Okay, then next is Abhinav Manushya. Kavita ke kavi ka naam likhiye. Name the poet of Abhinav Manushya. And answer is Abhinav Manushya kavita ke kavi ka naam hai Ramdhari Singh Dinkar. It is Ramdhari Singh Dinkar. Okay. Then next question. Adhunik Purush ne kis par vijay prapt ki hai? What has the modern man conquered? Answer. Adhunik Purush ne prakruti par vijay prapt ki hai. Modern man has conquered nature. Okay. Then next question. नर किन किन को एक समान लांग सकता है? What can man cross today? Answer, नर नदी सरिता और सागर को एक समान लांग सकता है. Man can cross sea, river, ocean identically, means at the same time. Then next question, आज मनुज का यान कहाँ जा रहा है? Where is man's vehicle going today? आंसर, आज मनुज का यान गगन में जा रहा है. टुडे मैन्स व्हीकल इज गोइंग इन द स्काई. देन नेक्स्ट मेन इज दो तीन वाक्यों में लिखो. आंसर इन टू टू थ्री सेंटेंसेस. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, प्रकृति पर सर्वत्र है विजय आसीन, इस पंक्ति का आशय समझाइए. ओके, यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस लाइन. प्रकृति पर सर्वत्र है विजय आसीन. It means everywhere there is victory over nature. So you have to explain how come. Answer is, इस पंक्ति का आशय यह है कि आज मानव के लिए कुछ भी असंभव नहीं है. प्रकृति के हर क्षेत्र में उसने विजय पाई है. Okay. Now the meaning of these lines are that today nothing is impossible for man. Yes, man has conquered in every field. He has become the leader of everything. परमाणु भी उसकी पहुंच से डरती है. इवन न्यूक्लियर वेपन्स आर अफ्रेड ऑफ मैन. ओके, सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द रीच ऑफ मैन. इवन न्यूक्लियर वेपन्स आर अफ्रेड ऑफ ह्यूमंस. ओके, सो फ्रॉम दिस लाइन यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड हाउ ह्यूमन हैज दिस गॉट विक्ट्री ओवर नेचर. देन नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, दिनकर जी के अनुसार मानव का सही परिचय क्या है? According to the poet Dinkar, what is the real identity of man? So answer is, Dinkar ji ke anusar bhautik pragati manav ki pehchan nahi hai balki uska swabhav hai. Ek manav ka dusre manav ke prati prem hona zaruri hai. Aapas ki duri ko mitakar rishta jode rakhna manav ki asli pehchan hai. Yes, so here worldly, it is a bhautik pragati means worldly progress, or you can say material progress. So according to the poet, this material progress is not the identity of man, but it is his nature, his behavior, his character. Yes, so it is necessary to have love for other human. you should respect the differences, because no two people will talk same, no two people will think same. So we should respect the differences. One should not have jealous in the heart for others. We should maintain good and healthy relationship. So this is the real identity of man. Okay, now the next question. Is kavita ka dusra kaun sa shirshak ho sakta hai? Kyun? What could be the second title of this poem and why? So see, this answer can differ because you yourself have to give a new shirshak, a new title. And when you are giving a new title, you have to explain why you have given that. Okay, you have to give the reason. So let us see the answer. Is kavita ka dusra shirshak aadhunik purush manav ki pehchan ya manushya ki udaan de sakte hai? Kyunki manav aaj aakash se patal tak ki sari jankari hasil kar chuka hai, sabhi cheez uske hukm par chalti hai. Okay, here the second title of this poem can be given aadhunik purush or manav ki pehchan or manushya ki udaan. Anything you can give. I have given three titles, any you can give. And also you have to write the reason why you have given that title. Today humans are filled with knowledge, no doubt. They know everything about the sky, space, earth, sea, ocean, below the ocean, everything. They are packed with knowledge. Everything runs on the advice of human. So you can give these type of titles, okay? Then next main is bhavarth likhe. You have to explain in detail. You have to write the meaning, okay, of these lines. Yeah, manuj jo srushti ka shringar, gyan ka vigyan ka alok ka agar, vyom se patal tak sab kuch ise hai ge, par na ye parichay manuj ka na yah na uska shre. You have to explain these lines. So here, in panktiyon ko अभिनव मनुष्य पद्य से लिया गया है जिनके कवि रामधारी सिंह दिनकर है। कवि कहते हैं कि मनुष्य से ही प्रकृति सुंदर बना है। मनुष्य को ज्ञान, विज्ञान, आकाश, पाताल का सभी कुछ पता है, परंतु वह अपने भाईचारे को नहीं पहचाना, वह अपनी असली पहचान भूल गया। ओके, सो दीज लाइन्स आर टेकन फ्रॉम द पोयम अभिनव मनुष्य हुज पोएट इज Ramdhari Singh Dinkar. According to this poet, man has decorated the nature because he knows everything about science, sky, space, etc. But in spite of having so much of knowledge, he has failed to recognize his brotherhood, bhaichara, brotherhood. Okay, he failed to understand his true identity. So these are the meaning of those lines. Then tukant shabd likhiye. Next main is tukant shabd likhiye. Tukant shabd means rhyming words. You have to pick the rhyming words from the poem and write. First is bhap. The rhyming word of bhap is tap. Then vyavadhan saman, shringar agar, ye shre, jeet preet. Okay, so these are the tukant shabd rhyming words. Then next main is panktiya purn kijiye, complete the poem. This is easy, you can write it. Aaj ki duniya vichitr naveen, prakruti par sarvatra hai vijayi purush aaseen, hai bandhe nar ke karo mein vari vidhut bhaap, hukum par chadta utarta hai pavan ka taap. Then next main is paryayvachi shabd likhiye, it means synonym. Okay, it means a synonym. You have to write word which has same meaning but different word. Like duniya. Duniya means world. So what can be the other word of duniya? Sansar, jagat. Okay, all this means same. All this carry the same meaning. Duniya, sansar, jagat. Okay, like this. Then second is vichitra. Vichitra means weird. So what else you can say for weird? Ajeeb, anokha. Okay, then next naveen. Naveen means new, naya, nav. Nar means human, manav, manushya, manuj, anything you can write. Then vari means water, pani, jal, amrut. Okay, you can write like that. Then kar means hand, hath, hast. देन आगार, आगार मीन्स बिग होम, खजाना, घर. ओके देन नेक्स्ट मेन इज विलोम शब्द, ऑपोजिट वर्ड. आज, कल, टुडे, टुमारो. नवीन, प्राचीन, मॉडर्न, एंशियंट. चढ़ता, उतरता, राइज, फॉल. समान, असमान, इक्वल, अनइक्वल. ज्ञान, अज्ञान, नॉलेज, इग्नोरेंस. जीत, हार, सक्सेस, फेलियर. असीमित, सीमित, अनलिमिटेड, लिमिटेड. देन तोड़, जोड़, टू ब्रेक, टू जॉइन. देन एक शब्द लिखिए. हियर अ सेंटेंस विल बी गिवन, यू हैव टू राइट वन वर्ड विच विल गिव यू द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट सेंटेंस. ओके सी द फर्स्ट वन इज आसन पर बैठा हुआ. सो यू हैव टू राइट वन वर्ड विच मीन्स आसन पर बैठा हुआ. सो दैट इज आसीन. आसीन मीन्स आसन पर बैठा हुआ. So instead of writing a big sentence, you have to write one word which will give you the same meaning. Okay. Now the second one, bacha hua means left over. It is sanchit. Then manu ki santan means manav, manushya, human. Then vishesh gyan, vigyan means scholar. No, not scholar, it is science. Vigyan means a science. Okay. Then adhik vidya prap, vidwan. Vidwan means scholar. Then next main, anurup shabd likhiye. Here you have to look at the first pair and solve the second pair. See, the first one is giri pahad. If giri, if the answer for giri is pahad, then what will be the answer for vari? You have to see the relation between the two, giri and pahad. What it is? It is synonym, it is antonym, it is a rhyming word, or what it is? You have to see that comparison, how these both are compared. So the same way you have to solve the second pair, giri pahad. It is the meaning of giri is pahad. So you have to write the meaning of vari, which is jal. Okay, pahad means mountain and jal means water. Next is pavan. Pavan and vayu. What is the relation between the two? Pavan and vayu. Pavan means air, vayu means air. Both means air. So here also meaning is given. So you have to write the meaning of sindhu. Sindhu, sagar means ocean. Okay. Then third one, zameen, asman. It is opposite. Zameen, asman. Earth, sky. So for Akash also, you have to write the opposite. Akash, sky, opposite of sky is patal, means lower part of the earth. Like that, you have to compare, you have to see, then you have to solve the second pair. Then next is nar, aadmi. Nar means human. Aadmi means human. So here meaning is given. So you have to write the meaning of ur. Ur means hruday, heart. Okay. So here we have done all the question answers of this chapter, or sorry, poem. In one video, I have given you all the question answers objectives. So if this video was useful and if you want more such videos, then hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Till then, take care.